Hi, I'm Becky from KiwiCo, and today we're going to be building a pinball machine. We're going to be using the science of collisions and forces and springs, all to be making the craziest, coolest custom pinball machine. So I hope you guys are ready to get rolling. All right, first we're going to assemble the plunger. Find this light blue piece and orient it just like this. Then we're going to take the plunger and slide it in so that the spring is in front of this little gate right here. When you pull the plunger back, it should want to spring forward. If not, double check that the spring is in the correct position. It won't work if the spring looks like this. All right, now that our plunger is assembled correctly, let's lock it all into place with this small blue piece. Click. If it's installed properly, the end of the plunger should line up with the little hole in this piece and should conceal the spring completely. All right, next we're gonna grab this big board, make sure the logo is facing up, and then install the plunger in these little two holes on the side. It should click into place. Double check that this little tooth is all the way through the board. Nice. All right, so there's two of these pieces and they look exactly the same. Find the notch on the taller side of the piece and then slide that onto your plunger. Just like that. And do the exact same thing with the second piece. The bottom of the pieces and that clover-shaped hole should all line up. Next, find this long green standoff and push it up through the bottom of your pinball machine. It might take a little bit of muscle, but that's because we want it to be nice and snug. Push it all the way up until it's sitting flush. You can get a grown-up to help if it's kind of hard. All right, next let's install the ball catch. So kind of the same thing, we're gonna line up that nub on the right side with the nub on the wood piece. Awesome. Next, we're gonna give a second leg to our pinball machine. Find this piece and slide it in that hole. To lock that foot into place, we're actually gonna sandwich two more pieces of wood on top of it. First, find this piece of wood with the big pill-shaped hole in it. Line up all the notches and slide it into place. It should fit just like this. Then, to lock it all together, grab a second tall green standoff, and again, you're gonna wanna push it up through the bottom of your pinball machine. Then, grab another long green standoff, and same thing, push it up through the bottom of your pinball machine. And again, double check that that standoff comes all the way up. Nice and flush. All right, the last layer of our sandwich is this nice faceplate. Make sure that these two small holes line up with the green standoffs. Then use two short green bolts to screw it into place. Everything should sit nice and flush and snug. If you want to tighten down your bolts, you can use any piece of 3mm wood or like a key or a coin from home. All right, now to get some more moving parts on this thing. Next, install a flipper in this big hole on the right. Make sure that's pointing towards the center of the pinball machine. Then, with one finger holding into place so it doesn't fall out, flip the whole thing over and we're gonna work from the back for a little while. Once it's flipped over, put one of these tiny wood pieces on the back of the flipper and secure it all down with another short green bolt. Make sure it's nice and snug. This little teeny tiny nub should be pointing towards the center of the pinball machine. Then take this big plastic blue piece and line it up just like so. One of those little nubs is gonna go into the slot on that wood piece we just screwed in. To make sure it's in the right spot, go ahead and give that little tiny wooden piece a wiggle and it should pull your blue piece back and forth. All right, now that we know it's in the right spot, we can lock it into place with this little yellow clip. Then to give a bit of spring misstep, stretch an O-ring between these two posts. Nice, you just assembled your first flipper. When you press it from the side, it should return back to its original position. Then repeat the same steps on the other side to build the second flipper. All right, you built both flippers. Let's flip the pinball machine over and give it a check. When you hit both the buttons on the side, the flipper should flip-flap just like this. If the flippers aren't moving at all, it might be because those blue pieces aren't in the grooves of the wood circles anymore. So push this yellow piece all the way down and double check that the blue pin is in the slot. Push it all the way in. Double check, it's working great. Awesome, so both of these little points should be facing each other. Flip it over, and all right. Whenever we press the sides, the flippers are going up. So, with your pinball machine face down, find these light blue pieces and put them on just like so. The plus sign and the screw hole should be pointing you if you're looking at the underside of the board. Then flip it over so you're looking at the top. Should be nice and smooth. All right, now we can set that aside for a second. Now to build the other half of the pinball machine. Look for the little etched triangle on this big piece and make sure that it's pointing up. Then grab two of these big blue legs and put them up through the bottom of the piece. Great. Triangle should still be up. Then grab these two pieces of really thick wood and snap them on top. Everything should line up nice and flush, and then the big long parts of those legs should be sticking out the bottom. Perfect. Then find the thin piece with the small holes and line it up on top. Go ahead and secure it into place with two small green bolts. Screw them in nice and tight. Friendly reminder, you can use anything that is 3 millimeters thick or less to help screw in this part. All right, now to put everything together. With both halves flipped over, go ahead and line up those plus signs and circles. Everything should press together nice and snug. All right, next, find this funky looking blue piece and line it up so that all the holes match. This piece gets held on with a big long strap. Slide it down over top and then use a bolt to secure it into place. Awesome. Before moving on, check it out from the side and make sure that everything's nice and straight and flush. If not, give it a good squeeze and tighten those screws down. All right, this is looking like a pinball machine. Next, we're gonna grab this flexible piece of plastic. You'll notice a bit of a tab on the bottom. If you give the plastic a slight bend, it should fit into the slot really well. This will help guide the ball back down to the flippers. We'll do a similar thing on the other side, but first we need to make sure that this tab is fully folded over. Perfect. And then these two little notches we're gonna line up in this hole, and then this big tab we're gonna slide into that slot. It might take a little bit of wiggling, but everything should fit nice and snug. Once everything's in place, go ahead and push that little flap at the top all the way towards the edge of the board. This little flap actually keeps the ball out on the play field for much longer and prevents it from rolling back down from where you launched. Next, look for this little piece. The peg over there lines up with the hole on the board, and that bigger circle cutout lines up with the bolt. All right, let's get playing. Okay, so we just finished building our pinball machine and now we're ready to play. But how do you even play pinball? Let's take it one step at a time. So step number one is you're gonna get one of your little ball bearings and just drop it right into this little hole right here. Next, you're gonna pull back the plunger and launch it onto the board. The whole game of pinball is about keeping the ball up on the board as long as possible. And the way we do that is with flippers. So the step number two is right after you launch it to grab these flippers right here and to get flipping. It helps if you put your thumbs right on either side to make sure it doesn't fly all around. So let's see that all together. So step one, you drop your pinball in. Step two, you launch. Step three, you use your flippers to keep it up on the board. And the last and most important step, have a great time. You might notice that your board is kind of bare right now, but that's why we've included a ton of awesome stuff to customize, like spinners and bumpers and catches. So let's get into all the things you can use to customize your board. So one of the basic things you have to customize in this crate is a peg. The pegs have a little squishy arm down here and a long part over on the other side, and the way you use them is you put this squishy part into any hole you want to. So I'm going to put this one here, and then I'm actually going to put in another one over here. And so what I can do with these is I can either put a spinner top on, so I can put the spinner top on and have it spin, or if I don't want the spinner, I can use the silicone bands and stretch it between for a way to bounce. So let's demonstrate that really quickly. So say I want to spin it over here. Yay, it spun. So I can move those around wherever I want to. And if I want to pull them out, take all the stuff up top and just pull. And if it's too hard, you can wiggle it side to side. That will help it come out. Another way you can customize this board is with our little catches. So the catches you can assign points with by choosing a sticker and sticking it on. And the catches face this way, so you want the numbers facing up. And the way this works is you stick it on the board. Another really fun way to play is to use this as a bonus ball, or in the way they say in pinball, a multi-ball. So you can actually just leave that in there. And then as you're playing your other game, see if you can knock it out. And then suddenly you have a second ball in play.
There's totally an endless number of possibilities for you to customize your board and design your own pinball machine. We put together three different versions that we think are super fun. So let's walk through those now.
We've got the Spin It to Win It, the Bouncerama, and the Zigzag Zapper.
So if you're running into any difficulty with your pinball machine, there's a couple ways to troubleshoot it. One of the first things we can look at is the flippers.
If your flipper is sitting funny or not reacting to the plunger, then you can try to push it back down or flip it over and double check that is in that groove. And if you move this, that's good. And these should be pointing in.
So if you're using your flippers and they kind of get stuck like here, or they don't want to return really quick and snappy, this blue part is too tight against the wood. So you just want to relieve some of that pressure. So this yellow piece, which is a wedge, when it's all the way in, it's tighter. The tightness is good, but if it's sticking, just push this wedge out a little bit, and that should allow it to move more freely. And then on the other hand, the flip side of that, if you're playing, and it's coming detached like that a lot, then actually push this yellow part all the way down, and that will hold it tighter. So that's why you can adjust this piece, and so yeah, have it all the way up. If you need it to move more freely, you push it all the way in if you want it to move more securely. If it's flexing in the middle, then you're going to want to turn it over and double check these screws. If these screws aren't tight, then there'll be a gap here that you'll need to fix. Also, make sure that the blue strap is sitting flat. If the blue strap is loose, make sure it's nested where it should go, and press the blue piece flat and tighten it down. Okay, now that we've gone through the troubleshooting and your pinball machine is working perfectly, let's get into the science behind how it works and why it works. So one of the most basic principles here about why a pinball machine is so much fun is one of the most basic physics principles you'll probably learn about, gravity. So whenever something is up, it must come down. The same principle applies here. Because of the shallow angle of the pinball field, the ball rolls back towards your flippers, meaning that every time you hit it away with your flippers, inevitably, it'll come right back. So it can make for some really fun gameplay where you can try to keep it up on the board for as long as possible. Kind of like when you're trying to keep a ball in the air for as long as possible with your friends, like a balloon or a volleyball. Same concept. So another really cool science principle that goes into how pinball machines work is something called energy. Sounds really basic, right? But there's two kinds of energy actually at play here. One is potential and one is kinetic. So when you pull back your plunger, you're actually storing a bunch of energy from your muscles into the spring. And then that spring has a bunch of potential energy. It's not doing anything yet, but it's about to. And when you let go of the spring, it unleashes all at once and turns that into kinetic energy, or energy in motion, as the ball flies out onto the field and rolls around.
So once that ball is full of kinetic energy and bouncing into the field, my favorite part of pinball starts to happen, and that's collisions. So as that ball flies onto the field, when it runs into something, some of that energy will go from the ball into whatever it hits, and so it'll kind of lose some steam as it's bouncing around until it makes a collision with your flipper. Once you smack that flipper and it hits the ball, you're actually putting more energy back into the ball. So it's kind of like recharging your pinball with more energy. Really cool. So that's some of the basic science behind what goes into pinball and why it's flying around so much. If you enjoyed learning about how it's built, how it's made, and how it works, then make sure to like and subscribe for much more content like that from us.